Dog fight. Dog fight. Oh no, how do you handle that? Dog fight.
Hi, I'm Rebecca Brandt and I'm at the Santa Barbara Fish Market. It's a Saturday morning and the fishermen come out here between 6 in the morning to 11 to sell their fish freshly caught off their boats. It's an incredible day at the harbor. It's a little overcast. I'm going to get some healthy fish to eat today. There's my friend Heidi. Say hi, Heidi. We had this idea together. She's definitely going to be 6 feet apart from me. This is our hello dance. Rather than the hug, we give the hello dance. Isn't that fun? Okay, let's go shopping.
There are so many delicious things to choose from here. The crabs look delicious.
These are my favorite kind of seafood.
I did a really good job of them.
Yeah. You can eat them raw. They're all alive.
Oh, wow. Oh, those look great. And how much are they per pound?
These are $20.
Good, so I get 8 of these guys for $20. That's a good deal. At a restaurant, you pay $50 for 2.
Exactly. Oh. So you're getting them direct from us.
I'm going to get a pound, okay? Oh, he's having a good time. Yeah. Well, I'm going to take 8 of those. That's fantastic. Thank you. Okay, you're not going to name them, are you, Heidi?
No.
This is a demonstration of how you eat the raw. Is it still alive? Oh, it's just going down the hatch.
It's not quick getting him out.
Okay, he's gonna eat this raw like sushi in the morning.
Are they sweet?
Yeah. Oh, okay, not even any soy sauce. You're just having a raw, okay. Well, this is what we do in Santa Barbara, folks.
Yeah.
Mm.
One of his trophies.
Culture abalone from our local waters. How much is your abalone?
So we do 6 abalone for $40 or we do 10 for $60.
10 for 60, wow, they look great.
That's 6 pounds, so we have 18. We go from 30 to 48.
Everybody is practicing very good social distancing. This group came in together and they have masks on and they're looking to buy something. There's some people at the railing here. I got a ticket from my friend that said, do not lean on that railing. Now you have to wash your clothes. And she was right. She was right. I was distracted. A guy that ate the shrimp, who actually had COVID, he was skiing in France and he got it. He thinks he got it from the gondolas. So that's something. He said he had all the symptoms, including the diarrhea, some coughing, but he said he didn't get it that bad. You know, he says he thinks the smokers are the ones that are gonna really have the bad stuff. These are the beautiful restaurants that I usually go to every week. There's Brophy's upstairs there with the plastic on the windows. That's my favorite Santa Barbara place on a Sunday afternoon. You'll always see me there. These girls are great. They have their masks on. There's Heidi over there. She's got her mask on. She's such a good girl. She's such a great friend. We had been traveling to Turkey right before the pandemic, or right during the pandemic, and made it back to America before it hit. And so she's my traveling buddy, my dear friend. So we drove separate cars because we wanted to get some fresh fish today. So not everybody in Santa Barbara has got the put on your mask memo, but the guy from France I talked to said he already had it. So, and it was a long time ago, so he probably feels like, well, I'm not gonna give it to anybody. And since it's not a requirement, I'm not gonna wear it. I get that sense that maybe if people thought they had it, they don't wear masks. Now when the trucks come, everybody has to smush together. So we haven't thought about that. Yeah, this is Paul.
Hi.
Your son, August. How's August doing?
August's back here.
Oh, he's great.
Grown up now.
This is so good. What a great idea. You've done your plastic glass with plastic.
Yeah, I want to make sure people feel safe.
Yeah, this is so fantastic, Paul. That's so great. And so are you out fishing commercially or is it just for the Saturday market?
Excuse me. Right now, the Saturday market is my only source of income.
Really?
So the restaurant that I sell to down in San Pedro absolutely shut down. And they usually have a seating capacity of 3,000 people with a 2-hour line waiting to get in on a Sunday. So they buy a lot of my product. And this is it's pretty devastating, but the community is really supporting us, and we see more and more people coming down and buying fresh product. And And so hopefully in the end, people will get used to buying directly from the fishermen. And this will be the new way to, for everyone to do business.
Yeah, you know, we're learning more about cooking and feeling comfortable making special meals at home. So if the restaurant industry doesn't come back quickly, we'll be able to do this at home to have our own special dinners with our friends.
Yeah. I haven't been out to dinner for months. I still have the same $50 in my wallet.
I know, we're all saving the restaurant budget, aren't we? Wow, well, what do you have? What kind of fish are you catching, Paul?
We focused on ocean whitefish.
Oh, those are great.
The rockfish season has been closed for 2 months. Seasonally, it closes March and April, so May 1st, rockfish will open. We have red and brown rock crabs for 15 minutes in boiling water. After you cook them, you peel the shell off. It comes off quite easy. And then you cut the crab in half and you rinse and scrape. And then you cut each leg section off like this. And it gives you access to the meat that's inside the body. And if there's any little pieces in the honeycomb, you can pull it out with that little pointy tool.
Oh, that's your pick.
That's your pick right there.
That's your seafood pick. Oh, what a good idea.
And they're quite delicious. It's a great presentation. My wife puts them in a big chafing dish and serves them like that for big crowds.
Oh, wow. That sounds great. Two whitefish.
Okay.
And then can I have you fillet it? Would that be okay?
They'll be doing it next door.
Great. They have a... Oh, terrific. Love it. That'll work.
So first we take the scales off.
Okay, you got a scaler there. I got both of these fish for only $13. That is such a deal. I can't believe it.
And pretty darn fresh, too.
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, just caught today.
You'll really taste the difference.
So what are you doing? You're cutting against the spine.
Yep. So you can hear that sound right there. And that means that there's no more meat left on that.
Wow, what a good job of filleting. You're not wasting a thing.
Nope.
You take it off.
Yeah, that comes off really fast with that.
Okay, then the other side.
And then you do your trail cut. And then just grab it right here.
Okay, so you're going down the other side of the spine right now, is that correct?
Yep.
All the way down to the tail. And you're feeling your knife against the bone of that fish, is that correct?
Correct.
And then up to the tail, here we go.
And there's nothing left on that.
And so you just throw that away?
Yep. And this doesn't go to waste either. That goes to the crab fisherman.
Okay, then they use that as bait to catch the crab.
Yep.
Wow.
Everything here is reused.
And that's the guts, right?
Yep. You just trim it up a little bit. And then that's the rib cage as well. Now, I can either take this off and you can eat the rib cage, or...
What do you mean, eat the rib cage?
So there's some a little bit meat in between, like right here.
Oh, but those are bones. I don't want any bones.
All right.
Just in case, I might miss a bone. I don't trust myself.
Oh, you'll find them.
I'll find them. That's okay. We can miss the bones. Okay. There we go. He took the rib cage off. That's what it looks like. And that's one of the fillets. And how many ounces do you think? 4 ounces of that? That's about 4 ounces?
Yeah.
Okay.
Approximately.
Okay, then the other side.
And then you do your trail cut. And then just grab it right here.
Okay, so you're going down the other side of the spine right now, is that correct?
Yep.
All the way down to the tail. And you're feeling your knife against the bone of that fish, is that correct?
Correct.
And then up to the tail, here we go.
And there's nothing left on that.
And so you just throw that away?
Yep. And this doesn't go to waste either. That goes to the crab fisherman.
Okay, then they use that as bait to catch the crab.
Yep.
Wow.
Everything here is reused.
And that's the guts, right?
Yep. You just trim it up a little bit. And then that's the rib cage as well. Now, I can either take this off and you can eat the rib cage, or...
What do you mean, eat the rib cage?
So there's some a little bit meat in between, like right here.
Oh, but those are bones. I don't want any bones.
All right.
Just in case, I might miss a bone. I don't trust myself.
Oh, you'll find
them. I'll find them. That's okay. We can miss the bones. Okay. There we go. He took the rib cage off. That's what it looks like. And that's one of the fillets. And how many ounces do you think? 4 ounces of that? That's about 4 ounces?
Yeah.
Okay.
Okay.
Approximately.
It's an ocean whitefish, and the crabs will eat that with the crab fishermen.
Oh my gosh, yay. I love it.
And at this fish market, they have all these recipes just posted. You can get inspired to make all these different dishes, which is so exciting. I'm so happy to be here. It's such an amazing place to come. It's wonderful. It's our culture here in Santa Barbara to get all these fish fresh now. And now we're all learning. We can do this on Saturdays and come get it. Isn't that exciting? So Saturday night's fish night in Santa Barbara.
And that is good social distancing. The fishermen are talking to their customers over here and having a nice conversation about the ways of the world and the ways of what's going on. It's pretty special. It's such a community.
So this is my catch today. I got a whole bunch of those spot prawns in this bag. They're gonna get boiled up and dipped in butter. Okay, don't be mad at me for eating these things. I just put them in hot boiling water head first. That's my method. Thank you for going to the Santa Barbara Fish Market with me today at the harbor and this big, beautiful pier with all the fishermen that are trying to make a living since they no longer have any of that restaurant business. They're saying the community is coming out. They're buying the fresh fish as we're all cooking so much at home. Please make a comment and let me know what life is like in your town. What's the status of events? Our town is talking about reopening the town, and I just can't imagine that without having any testing still. Like nothing. Unless you're dying and going into the hospital, they don't even test you here. So it's just shocking to me that we can even have this discussion without testing. So it is very vital for our communities to practice social distancing because we can't test rapidly and with enough quantity to really know what's going on in our towns and to also stay inside if you haven't had it. If you've had it, you get to go outside if the antibodies are helpful enough to keep you from getting it again, which is on the table as well in a discussion and science. So many unknowns. So I hope you are safe and healthy. And if you have it, write us down. What are your symptoms? Like I did talk to that person today and I heard about his symptoms. Let us know and how your family is. And I wish you all good health and lots of love. Thank you for watching this video. Subscribe to the channel and ring the bell to get notified of my next video. And I wish you great life, great happiness, and to find some joy in this time on our planet. I'm Rebecca Brand. Bye-bye. Oh, dog bite. Dog bite. Oh, no. How do you handle that?
Hey, sorry.
Dog bite.
I was waiting till she finished.
You never know what's going to happen when the camera's on.